Welcome to the Introduction to UVs by Professor Foster. So what is UV mapping? It specifies how 2D images will be applied to 3D surfaces. What it means exactly is that we will take these UVs and we will it will specify how a texture will fit on a 3D object within this thing called the 0 to 1 space. We will also talk about keeping the size of the texture density consistent, and I'll define that. And we'll also make sure that the texture, the 2D texture that you create, isn't stretching across the object. Finally, by the end of this tutorial, you shall understand exactly these terminologies. What is a UV shell? What are texture borders? And what is texture density? Finally, I'm going to discuss the goal of UV mapping, which is the consistent application of 2D textures and the maximization of texture space. So let's get started in Maya. So I've created three objects. And on these objects, I've created a 2D texture in Photoshop. It's got letters and numbers on it, and I'll talk about how that helps us identify different attributes within the UVs. In addition to that, I'm going to also talk about, point out that these are square. This is a known square tile. And so now I've applied that to a shader in Maya, and I've had that tiled 3x3. So I've applied that shader to these objects. And to show the shader, I'm going to hit the 6 key. And so let's take a look at how this, just the default, is applying to these objects. Well, you can see that it looks like it's doing a great job just on the two-dimensional plane. But you can see already the stretching that's going on even this very simply modeled house, maybe. And also this silo, there's a little bit of stretching going on the top and a lot of stretching going around on the sides. So really we're going to focus on the house today in this tutorial. So I'm going to hide these other two objects. And I'm going to, so let's open up the UV editor, and that's under the polygon menu, and the edit UVs, UV texture editor is probably one of the fastest ways to get it. So when that opens up, you'll see a grid set, and really where we're going to focus is in this area. And so it's 0 to 1, and that's why it's known as the 0 to 1 space. And when we select the object, we'll see how its UVs are sort of displaying. And there's two buttons we're going to start out describing what their functions are. This button will display the texture borders. So when we apply a texture to this object, the texture borders will highlight on both the UV texture editor and on the screen. Now, sometimes you're going to want to have textures go seamlessly across borders, and there's tricks where we'll discuss how to accomplish that. But as you can see right now, there's if these were going to be bricks that needed to be lined up, we'd have a little bit of a problem going across this border. Some of the borders are connected, so like going across here. You can see this corresponds to this border. So, alright, so let's talk about how could we map this in a different way. Some people prefer to start with no UVs at all on their object. This is sort of the default. Anytime you start with a primitive object in Maya, it comes with some UVs. And some of the UVs will be laid out pretty nice, and some of them will need some tweaking immediately off the bat. I like to start blank. So I'll go in and delete the UVs so there's nothing to start out with. There's some default UV placement utilities inside of Maya that are pretty good for simple objects. Under the Create UVs menu, there's Planar Maps, which will create a one plane projection. And you can see how that projected. It's good for single sets of faces, and you can see how it put that into the 0 to 1 space. But it completely fails on the other sides where it didn't project. And then let's see how it went on the front and the back of the object. It worked perfectly on the front, but so you can see those textures are looking fine and they're facing the right way. But if we rotate this object, you can see these are flipped. So that takes us to the next button that I'm going to describe. This button will show if your UVs are facing the correct direction. If your UV shells are blue, they're facing the correct direction, and that'd be the direction of the surface normal. If they're red, then they're facing the wrong direction. And if they're pink, there's two shells overlapped, or in purple, they're overlapped. There's a couple other UV. There's cylindrically mapped UVs, and that looks pretty good, but it fails on the floor and on the top. Plus, it went beyond the 0 to 1 space, so we would have to fix that. And it's also getting some, there's definitely some warping up here. But that works great for cylinders. So there's spherical mapping, which works great for spheres, and automatic mapping will take, let's do that again. Automatic mapping will take 6 planar projections and do it all at once. And that's looking pretty good on our object here. Now, the next thing that I mentioned and what we're going to deal with is